Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God, praise God. Welcome, welcome, one and all, to the Thursday morning Berean Bible study here at Cross Covenant Ministries of Christ. We are ever so honored to have you all here on this day, joining us to traverse the vast richness of the glorious word of the living God. We give him praise, we give him glory, we give him honor because he is worthy, saints. He is so worthy, praise God, hallelujah. And if you have not yet found out just who he really is, oh, taste and see, hallelujah, that the Lord, he is good, hallelujah. The Lord, the covenant God, he is truly, truly good, hallelujah. And we give him praise in this place, praise God. So on this day, we're going to go ahead and continue forward in a study of Calvary's love. We're going to continue along the lines of the subheading, which is, behold, what manner of love. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Behold, what manner of love. Hallelujah. So just to get us started, we're going to ask my husband, Jeff, if he would please be so kind as to go ahead and lead us out in prayer. Praise God. Praise God.
My mic. There we go. Okay. Glory to God.
Praise God.
Let us bow our heads. Heavenly Father, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We come to you, Jesus. Lord, today, oh Lord, thanking you, Father, for who you are, Lord, and for what you've done, Lord. Glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name, Lord.
Thank you.
You are so worthy to be praised this morning. Glory to your name, Father. We enter your courts with thanksgiving and your gates with praise this morning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Blessed is the name of the Lord. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into and they are saved. Father, we thank you this morning, Lord. We magnify you this morning, Lord. We extol your name this morning, Father. We give you all the praise and glory and honor. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah. Blessed is the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, I don't have enough tongues, Father. I don't have enough tongues to give you what is due you. In the name of the Lord Jesus, thank you this morning. Heavenly Father, we thank you for Cross Covenant Ministries of Christ, Father. Hallelujah for sending us this way, Lord. 15 years ago, Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. To hear the message of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, soul-saving, life-changing, hallelujah. Glory to God. You quicken the flesh and you quicken the spirit, Father. In the name of the Lord Jesus, thank you this morning, Lord. Thank you for Pastor Victor E. Harris, Sister Sid Harris, Mother Lindsay, all the saints of God, hallelujah, at this body, Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus, the edification of the body, Lord, hallelujah, and the glorification of you. And you alone. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. You are the wheel in the middle of our wheel, Father.
Hallelujah.
You are the all and everything, Lord. You are the one true living God. Hallelujah.
Thank you,
thank you this morning, Father.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father. Thank you for the blood running warm in our veins. Thank you, Father, for the roof over our heads. Thank you for the cars we drive. We take so much for granted, Father. And your eye is on the sparrow. The very hairs on our head are numbered. You know all things, and you are everywhere, and you are all-powerful, Lord. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Man doesn't know what the future holds, but we know who holds the future. We know who holds the future. We know who holds the future. Hallelujah. Thank you this morning, Father. Thank you. Lead us and guide us today, Lord. Let us do no violence, Lord, to your word. Let us diminish and let your spirit increase, Heavenly Father, that we will say something to one who is weary. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you for your people, the Israel, Lord, Benjamin Netanyahu. We pray for Donald John Trump. We pray for all those in high places because that's where the spiritual wickedness is, in high places, Father. Lord, we thank you today. We thank you this morning, Father. Let us say something, O Lord. that will edify the body. And Lord, we ask all these blessings in your son Jesus' name. And the church said amen, 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 and amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
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 Blessed is the name of the Lord.
Praise
Hallelujah.
God. Praise
Glory
God.
To your
praise
name,
God.
Father.
Hallelujah.
Glory to your name.
Hallelujah. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So on this night, glory be to God, we're going to start off in the great book of 1 John chapter 3. Mm-hmm. We're going to read verses 1 through 3. Again, that is the great book of 1 John,
yes,
chapter
Lord.
3. We're going to have a look at verses 1 through 3.
Thank you, Lord.
When you have it, please be so kind as to say amen.
Amen.
Don't praise God. Mm-hmm. Praise God. All right. So the great word of God does read, "Behold, what manner of love, praise God,
Glory.
The Father has bestowed upon us. That we should be called the sons of God."
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
"Therefore, the world knows us not because it knew him not."
Yes.
Praise God. "Beloved, now are we the sons of God."
Hallelujah.
Praise
Thank you, Lord.
God.
Glory to you.
"And it does not yet appear
yes, Lord.
What we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear," praise God, "we shall be like him,"
Glory
praise
to God,
God.
Hallelujah.
"For we shall see him,"
yes, Lord,
"as he is."
Glory
Hallelujah.
To God. What a blessing.
Hallelujah.
Glory
"And
to God.
Every man who has this hope in him,"
yes, Lord,
"purifies himself," "even as he," the Christ, praise
yes,
God, "is pure."
Yes, Lord.
Praise
Jesus.
God.
Thank you, Father.
Praise God.
Glory
All
God.
Right. So we understand, praise God, that our Heavenly Father bestowed a certain type of love, praise God, a self-sacrificial love upon us, praise God, that we should be called the sons of God in order that he could welcome us or adopt us into the beloved, praise God.
That's
All right.
right.
So Glory now, let's just find out, let's go ahead and just quickly confirm, okay, who the beloved is, praise God.
Thank you,
so
Lord.
We are the sons of God in the beloved,
Amen.
Praise God. So who is the beloved, praise
Glory God.
God. All right, so let's go.
Thank you, Lord.
With me real quickly, please, if you don't, if you would be so kind. Over to the great book of Saint Matthew, okay, chapter 3. We're going to look at verses 16 through 17.
Amen.
Okay, so again, that is the great book of Matthew, chapter 3, starting at the 16th verse. We'll look at verses 16 through 17.
Amen.
And when you have verse 16, if you would please be so kind as to say amen.
Amen.
Okay. Honey, could you please be so kind as to go ahead and read that for us?
Amen. Yes, ma'am. We're saying Matthew chapter 3, starting with verse 16 and 17.
Verse 16 and 17, okay.
"And Jesus, when he was baptized, went up straightway out of the water, and lo, the heavens were open unto him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting upon him. And lo, a voice from heaven saying, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased."
Glory okay, saints.
God.
So do you hear
Hallelujah.
It there? This is my
yes,
beloved.
Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Glory to God.
Praise God.
Thank you,
so
Lord.
We understand that we are only the sons and the daughters of God because
yes,
he first loved us. Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
But moreover, when that we accept the sacrifice that the Lord Jesus gave for us on Calvary's cross, praise God, we are at that point adopted into the beloved. Who is the beloved? The beloved is Christ. Praise God. This is my beloved. Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
This is my beloved Son in whom I am well please. Praise God. Please go with me over to the great book of, go with us over to the great book of St. John, chapter 1 and verse 29. Again, that is the great book of St. John, chapter 1 and verse 29. Praise God. When you have it, please be so kind as to say amen.
Amen.
All right, praise God. Okay, honey, if you would please be so kind as to go ahead and read.
Amen. It would be a delight. 1 John chapter 1, verse 29. Mm-hmm. The next day, John sees Jesus coming unto him and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God, which takes away the sin of the world." Glory to God.
Okay, so again, as we read initially in 1 John chapter 3 and verse number 1, he said, "Behold, what manner of love." Look intently into the manner of love, praise God, that the Father has bestowed upon us, praise God. And here he tells us what it is that, or rather who it is that we are to behold.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
So he says it very plainly. He says, "Behold the Lamb of God." Praise God. And as Pastor Harris has taught here time and again, according to the word of God, praise God, just in the Old Testament, we see how that the priest would have to, you know, open up the lamb and examine the lamb.
Examine
praise
the
God.
Lamb.
Thoroughly examine the lamb. Okay? And this is the same thing that we as children of God must do. Why? Because as we read in verse 3, praise God, when we see him, when we truly see him and truly behold the lamb, we shall be like him. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. So what is the Father's highest intention? Is that we should be conformed into the image of the Son of the living God.
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah. This is why we must meditate in the Word. Praise God. Day and night. Praise God. Because we must look intently, purposefully, praise God, into who he is.
Amen.
Praise God. Into
Glory
what
God.
Manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us. Yes.
You know, we have to understand that this is in the mind of God. This is God that came up with this. It's not any man or someone that we know or a neighbor or a friend. We're talking about the maker of heaven and earth. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God Almighty,
amen.
This is in the mind of God, amen?
Amen.
That he would send his only begotten son, that he so loved the world. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Okay. And we know, praise God, amen. That, that this was of the Father's doing, praise God. If you would please be so kind as to go with us over to the great book of 1 John, chapter 4. We're going to look at verses 7 through 10. Again, that is 1 John, chapter 4. We're going to start with verse 7, and we're going to go through verse 10. And then we will skip over to chapter 5 and look at verses 6 through 12, okay? Again, 1 John chapter 4, verses 7 through 10, and then we're going to keep going right over into 1 John chapter 5, verses 6 through 12, okay? So, when you have verse 7, please be so kind as to say amen.
Amen.
Okay, honey, could you please share with us the word?
Hallelujah. Yes, ma'am. 1 John, this is chapter 4, verse 7 and 10. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who loves not knows not God, for God is love.
He is love.
And this was manifested, the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might live through him.
Praise God.
Glory
so
to God.
So again, And he'll reiterate it again here in verse number 10. But we see exactly, praise God, amen, who the love of God is, praise God, amen, and how the love of God was expressed to the entirety, hallelujah, of the world.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Okay, please continue.
Glory to God. Amen. You know, if I can just interject here, it says at the latter part of verse 9, it says that we might live through him. We might and we might not. Amen. That's so right. That lets us know right there that we have a choice. Amen. Amen. As Pastor Harris has spoke with us from the scriptures about choice. Verse 10. Herein is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his son to be the propitiation for our sins. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
And we're going to read that note.
Amen. Verse 10. Mm-hmm. Okay. Please. The first part of verse 10 or the latter?
The latter part. Yeah.
Propitiation is the sacrifice which fully satisfied the demands of the broken law and did so by our Lord's death on Calvary's cross. His death eternally satisfied the righteousness of God. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Glory to God.
And the reason that it did is because love is the fulfillment of the law. And this was the highest expression of love ever known to man. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Love came and he fulfilled the law.
Glory to God.
Okay. Please continue.
Amen. How far am I going to verse 11 next?
You're going over to verse chapter 5,
okay,
verse 6 through 12.
All right, verse 6 through 12, chapter 5. This is he who came by water and blood, even Jesus Christ. Not by water only, but by water and blood. And it is the Spirit who bears witness, because the Spirit is truth. Hallelujah. Amen. Capital T. For there are three who bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit. And these three are one. And there are three who bear witness in earth, the Spirit and the water and the blood. And these three agree in one. If we receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater. For this is the witness of God, which he has testified of his son. Hallelujah.
Okay. So
glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Keep going. Hang on,
verse 10. Hallelujah.
Hello. Oh, there it is. Okay. I'm sorry. I wouldn't. Okay. All right. So yeah. So I just wanted to touch on, just real quickly here, in verse number 9, he says, if we receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater. For this is the witness of God, which he testifies of his son. Isaiah 53, verse number 1 says, who has believed our report? Okay, this is the report of the Holy Trinity, praise God. Moreover, the report of the Heavenly Father regarding his son his beloved son in whom he is well pleased.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Glory to God.
Praise God.
Thank you.
So just want to clarify that, praise God, exactly who we are speaking of here, praise God. Because again, according to the word of God that we read in 1 John chapter 3 and verse 1, we are to behold, we are to look intently,
amen,
to thoroughly research and examine the Lamb, okay? And how do we do that? Well, we just saw right there in verse number 7. Yes, verse number 7.
Amen.
For there are three who bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word. Okay, so the expository study note here says Jesus Christ is the Word, okay? So, and to examine the Lamb, or to look intently into the manner of love that the Father has bestowed upon us so that we can enter into the beloved, means that we are to examine intently the Word of the living God. The Lord Jesus is the living word. Praise God. We have the written word. He is the living word, praise God, which we've gone over in times past over in the book of Revelation chapter 19. We won't go there on tonight for the sake of time, but he literally says his name is the word of God. Amen. Praise God. Okay, among other things, you know, Lord of Lords, King of Kings, praise God. His name is faithful.
Savior.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, so we just want to clarify that, praise God. But this is the record given to us of the Father, of his Son, praise God, hallelujah. So if you do not believe the word of God, then you are rejecting the Father's report regarding his Son, his beloved Son, in whom he is well pleased, praise God, okay, all right. We're going to go ahead and continue forward just down to verse number 12, and then we're going to look at how dangerous that is, and we'll continue forward. But please continue, please.
Okay, let me get back over there. I'm sorry. I was looking for something, and let me get back.
Okay.
First John chapter 5, right?
Uh-huh.
And where did I stop at?
You stopped at verse 10.
Okay.
No, you stopped at verse 9. I'm sorry, verse 9, uh-huh.
He who believes on the Son of God has the witness in himself. He who believes not God has made him a liar, because he believes not the record that God gave of his Son. Good gracious alive. Mm-hmm. And this is the record that God has given to us eternal life.
Praise God.
And this life is in his Son. Glory to God.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the only
Hallelujah.
Place for, a dead and decaying, sin-filled, wretched man, the Apostle Paul said, "O wretched man that I am, who shall deliver me from this body of death?" Praise God. I thank my God. Hallelujah. I thank my God. Praise God for the Lord Jesus, praise God, the one who came and died for us all. Now, let's go right on over, if you would please be so kind with us, to the great book of Hebrews chapter 10. We're going to look at verses 5 through 10, and then we're going to skip on over to verse 26 through 31, okay? But first, we'll start with verse number 5. Again, that's Hebrews chapter 10, verses 5 through 10, and then we'll go verses 26 through 31. When you have verse number 5, if you would please be so kind as to say amen, giving glory to his holy name.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Okay. Praise God. So for the sake of time, we're going to go ahead and continue forward. But so he says, "Wherefore, when he comes into the world," hallelujah, we understand that he, praise God,
hallelujah,
is the lover of our souls and the lifter up of our heads. Hallelujah. He is the Lord Jesus, the Christ. He is the covenant God. Hallelujah. All right. He said, "Sacrifice and offering ye would not." Okay. So it was not sufficient, praise God.
Yes, Lord.
To pay for man's sin debt. Okay.
Amen.
But the Lord Jesus was, as we just read, our propitiation, praise God. All right. He was the only acceptable sacrifice, praise
Amen.
God. He was only possible. Okay. Option. Okay. There was no man, no woman, no child, no beast who was worthy, no, not one, but
Amen.
He. All right? So he says, "Sacrifice and offering ye would not, but a body have you prepared me." Hallelujah.
Amen.
"In burnt offerings and sacrifices for sin ye have had no pleasure." Praise
yes,
God. Because
Lord.
They were just a shadow, praise God,
Hallelujah.
A pointer to the glorious King of
Hallelujah.
Kings and Lord of Lords,
Glory
the
to God.
Savior of the world, the
Amen.
Messiah. Hallelujah to his name. Praise
Amen.
God.
Amen.
We worship him, the Messiah over all. All right, so he says, you have had no pleasure, praise God. But
hallelujah.
You see, the Lord Jesus came, and he alone is the sweet-smelling savor,
hallelujah.
Praise
thank
God,
thank you, Lord.
In the nostrils of the Father.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Lord.
All right, so he says, then said I, lo, I come, praise God.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Now, you know, in today's society, you have a lot
thank
of children
you,
that aren't really all that worried about their father's or their parents' pleasure, praise God, or about their comfort. You see, it's all about me and what can I get and when do I get mine. But you see,
that's right.
Right after he says here, in burnt offerings and sacrifices for sin, you have no pleasure. You had no pleasure, praise God. We see he says, then said I, praise God. So this is not only love for mankind, but this is also a love for his Father.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So he says, then said I, lo, I come. Hallelujah. In the volume of the book, it is written of me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To do your will, O God. Hallelujah. The Lord Jesus said, my meat
thank
is
you,
to
Lord.
Do the will of my Father. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you,
praise
Lord.
God. Hallelujah. All right. So that is his sustenance. Praise God.
Amen.
So he says, above when he said sacrifice and offering and burnt offerings and offering for sin, you would not, neither had pleasure therein, which are offered by the law.
Amen.
Then said he said it again, praise God. We know it's important if he says it once, but twice, praise God, we had better behold. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, lo, I come to do your will, O God. Hallelujah. He takes away the first that he may establish the second by the which will, praise God, we are sanctified.
Hallelujah.
Through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise God.
Glory
all right.
To God.
So all of this just gets gooder and gooder. Praise God. As
hallelujah.
My husband has said in times past. But for the sake of time, we're going to drop down to verse 26. Praise God.
Amen.
And he says, For if we sin willfully, praise God. All right. After that, we have received the knowledge of the truth.
Glory
okay.
God.
After that, we have heard the Father's report regarding his Son.
Amen.
Hallelujah. His beloved Son in whom he is well pleased. Praise God. He says, there remains no more sacrifice for sins. Why? Because we already read that the Lord Jesus is our propitiation for the sins.
That's
praise
right.
God.
Glory to God.
If we reject him, if we reject the Lamb of the living God, the sacrificial Lamb of God, praise God.
Glory to God.
He was self-sacrificial. Praise God. Then we understand, praise God, that there remains no more sacrifice for sins. Praise God.
Amen.
But a certain fearful looking for of judgment and fiery indignation. Praise God.
Amen.
Which shall devour the adversaries.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He who despised Moses' law died without mercy under two or three witnesses.
Amen.
Of how much more, of how much sorer punishment, hallelujah, suppose ye shall he be thought worthy who has trodden underfoot the Son of God.
Amen.
And has counted the blood of the covenant wherewith he was sanctified an unholy thing.
Glory to God.
You see, if that we reject the love that he has shown, praise
hallelujah.
God. He says, and has done despite unto the spirit of grace.
Amen.
Praise
God.
God.
Hallelujah.
For we know him who has said, vengeance belongs unto me.
Yes, Lord.
I will recompense, saith the Lord. Praise God.
Thank you,
and
Father.
Again, the Lord shall judge his people. Okay?
Thank you, Lord.
It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God.
Hallelujah.
Thank hallelujah.
You, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And you know, this is really great, honey. What we see here, as from what you just read from the scriptures,
praise
we
God.
See that the Son's love that he had for his Father.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
But then you see also that God gave Moses the sacrificial law. about the animals, you know, the sacrificing, the great day of atonement, and the morning and evening sacrifice. But it says he had no pleasure in verse 6 and verse 8.
That's right.
He repeats it. The reason why he didn't have any pleasure, saints, is because the sacrificial system was supposed to be just to show us of the one, the Messiah, who was to come.
Amen.
We were supposed to have a love for him back then, and even more so now that we look back at the cross where the Lord Jesus shed and gave up his life's blood. Amen?
Amen.
And so if you don't have that relationship with God, if you don't study the Lord Jesus, if you don't examine the Lamb and continually study his word and have that love relationship with him, we'll be just like the children of Israel. And we know what happened to them in the wilderness. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise
Thank
God.
You, Lord.
Ever learning, but never able to come into the knowledge of the truth.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Glory to God.
If we reject the propitiation, the Lord's beloved, praise God.
Hallelujah.
The Father's beloved, the Lamb of the living God, praise God. Then light rejected is light withdrawn.
Amen.
Praise God.
Thank you, Father.
All right. Praise God. So just real quickly, we'll take the time just to reiterate one of the very rich scriptures that Pastor Harris has been going over here. Praise God. As of late, praise God, according to the word of God, because it falls right in line here with what we are all saying. Praise God. And
Amen.
Again, that is the great book of Jeremiah, chapter 9, verses 23 through 24. Okay, again, that's the great book of Jeremiah, chapter 9, verses 23 through 24. When you have verse 23, if you would please be so kind as to say amen.
Amen. Glory to God.
Okay, praise God. If you would please be so kind as to go ahead and read that for
amen.
Us.
Amen. Jeremiah chapter 9, verse 23. Thus says the Lord, let not the wise man glory in his wisdom.
Praise God.
Neither let the mighty man glory in his might. Mm. Let not the rich man glory in his riches.
Praise God.
But let him who glories glory in this, that he understands and knows me.
Amen.
Glory to
Amen.
God.
Amen. Praise
Hallelujah.
God. Okay, so therein is our glory.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Amen.
Therein is the only glory that we need. Praise God. Hallelujah. You see, the same thing was so for Adam and Eve there back in the garden. Praise God. They had the glory of the Father. You see, they had the knowledge of the Almighty. Praise
yes,
God.
Is.
They
yes,
were covered
is.
In his glory,
Hallelujah.
Praise God. But
Thank
after that,
Lord.
They rejected the word of God. They rejected
yes,
the
Lord.
Covenant God. They rejected the word of the commandment of the Lord. Praise God.
Amen.
That glory was taken away from
Hallelujah.
Them. Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
Okay, because they rejected him. And if you would go right over to Jeremiah chapter 10 and verse number 10, we see further confirmation here where the great word of God tells us. But the Lord is the true God. He is the living God. Now, we just read over in Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 31, I want to say. But the Lord God is the true God. He is the living God. Okay, it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of a living God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All right, so it tells us clearly who he is. And an everlasting king. At his wrath, the earth shall tremble, and the nation shall not be able to abide his indignation.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm sorry. Okay, so just real quick.
Thank you, Lord.
We need to understand and recognize that repentance is a privilege.
Hallelujah. Thank
Repentance
you, Lord.
Is a privilege, and we don't recognize the privilege, the great
Hallelujah.
Privilege that it is.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise God, until the time comes that it is no longer available to us, saints. And repentance is only available in the same place that mercy is available, and that's on this side of glory.
Amen.
Okay?
Glory to
so
God.
We must seek the Lord while he may be found.
Amen.
Praise God. Seek him early.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Honey, I just wanted to exergy on this statement here, what it says. Don't glory in what you have, your wisdom, your glory, your might, your riches. Mm-hmm. It says the glory in that he understands and knows me.
That's right.
You know, I like to use the analogy of, you know, we might know about, or we read about, or maybe even seen on television, a heart transplant. You know, somebody go into somebody's chest and replace their heart. But you know what? That's a totally different ball game to understand and know. If you are in that operating room and somebody hand you that scalpel and you about to make that first cut, that's a totally different ball game. To understand and to know the one true living God.
Amen.
He said, study, handle me, study me to understand and to know. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like a mechanic. If I go to a mechanic, I might know a little bit about a car, but if he talks about replacing a transmission or an engine, and Pastor Harris used that analogy the other day on his truck, you know, it's a totally different ball game when you get under that truck or that car and you got to take out that transmission.
That's right. Amen.
Amen. So we're talking about understanding and knowing the maker of heaven and earth. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank
Praise
you, Lord
God.
Jesus.
Praise God.
Thank you, Father.
All right. So he gives us, praise God, an example of the Father's love.
Amen.
Over in, praise God, the great book of Genesis, chapter 22, verses 1 through 13. Again, that is the great book of Genesis, chapter 22, starting at the first verse, going through the 13th verse, okay? This is the beautiful example that he gives to us, praise God, of his love for his son. You see, Amen. He wants us to know and to understand that he did not just give us anything, praise God.
Hallelujah.
He did not just send down any creature, praise God.
Glory.
Okay. He sent, praise God, his only begotten son.
Hallelujah.
Praise
Thank
God.
You,
he sent the promised
Amen.
Child.
Yes, he did.
Praise God.
Glory.
He sent a miracle.
Yes, Lord.
Okay. Praise God. He sent us heaven's best.
Yes, he did.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
And he gives us a glimpse of this in Genesis chapter 22. Verses 1 through 13. Honey, would you please be so kind as to share this with us, please?
Yes, ma'am. And it came to pass after these things that God did tempt Abraham and said unto him, Abraham. And he said, Behold, here I am. And he said, Take now your son, your only son Isaac, whom you love, and go into the land of Moriah and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell you of. And Abraham rose up early in the morning and saddled his donkey and took two of his young men with him and Isaac his son and clave the wood for the burnt offering and rose up and went unto the place of which God had told him. Then on the third day,
mm-hmm.
glory to God,
praise God,
Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place afar off. Mm. And Abraham said unto his young men, Abide here with the donkey, and I and the lad will go yonder and worship. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
And come again to you. And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it upon Isaac his son. And he took the fire in his hand and a knife, and they went both of them together. Mm. And Isaac spoke unto Abraham his father and said, My father. And he said, Here am I, my son. And he said, Behold, the fire and the wood, mm-hmm. but where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Mm-hmm. And Abraham said, My son, God will provide himself a lamb for the burnt offering.
Hallelujah.
So they both went both of them together. Mm-hmm. And they came to the place which God had told them. And Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac his son. Mm-hmm. And laid him on the altar upon the wood. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son.
Praise God.
And the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, Here I am. And he said, Lay not your hand upon the lad, mm-hmm. neither do you anything unto him. For now I know that you fear God, seeing you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in a thicket by the thorns, mm-hmm. by the horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering instead of his son. Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let me finish with verse 14. And Abraham called the name of that place Jehovah Jireh.
Praise God.
Meaning the Lord will provide. As it is said to this day, in the mount of the Lord it shall be seen. Glory
Hallelujah.
To God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Bless the name of the
Praise
Lord.
God.
Glory
Praise
to your name.
God. Behold,
Jesus.
What manner
Hallelujah.
Of love,
of
Hallelujah,
God
the Father
has
bestowed, praise God, upon us, Hallelujah, Hallelujah, praise
Thank
God,
you,
praise God. Now, glory be to God. Now,
hey,
this
Lord.
Story gives the Father's
Hallelujah.
Point of view, praise
yes.
God.
Yes.
It shows us
mm.
the Father's heart,
mm.
praise God. It gives us just a glimpse.
Yes, it does.
Into the Father's experience,
His
you
love.
See.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. So he
Thank
says
you,
here in verse 1, he says, And it came to pass after these things that God did tempt. Now, the word tempt here, we see here in the expository study note, he says should have been translated as test or prove, okay? So the Lord does prove us.
Yes,
Praise
he does.
God. Okay? The Lord proves us. So that he can, not because he doesn't know the state of our heart, but so that we can know the state of our heart, praise God, so that we can know if we truly do love him, praise God, all right? So, of course, also we see here in verse number 2, he says, And he said, Take now your son, your only son, Isaac, whom you love, praise God.
Amen.
So the Holy Spirit and all his wisdom, praise God, chose to point that out,
Amen.
That this was his only son. This was
Glory.
His promised child. This was his miracle.
That's right. Glory
praise
God.
God.
Amen.
This was his miracle.
Amen. That's right.
Praise God.
Glory
okay.
God.
This was his joy.
Hallelujah.
Isaac's name means laughter.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Glory
okay.
To God.
This was his beloved, okay? And
Amen.
he clarifies it for us. He says, whom you love, and go into the land of Moriah.
Mm.
Now, Moriah, the name Moriah here means Jehovah is provider, praise
Amen.
God. So he did well in verse 14 to say Jehovah Jireh, praise
Amen.
God.
Amen.
The Lord will provide, okay?
Hallelujah.
So because he was in the land of Moriah, okay? The Lord sent him there.
Amen.
Okay? The Lord always sends us into his way of provision,
yes,
praise God.
Hallelujah.
Okay? So along with the temptation, he does always make a way.
Amen.
Praise
Hallelujah.
God. He cause, and the truth of the matter is because he's already made the way. Hallelujah.
Yes, he is. Hallelujah.
Okay. Were you trying to
I
say
just, yeah, I was going to, what you mm-hmm. saying about tempting where it says
mm-hmm.
the Lord did tempt Abraham.
Mm-hmm.
I just wanted to, if I can interject,
okay.
This is in Deuteronomy chapter 13.
Okay. Now hold your place.
Stay where you're at. Stay where you're at.
But, yes.
I'm just going to read this real quick. Deuteronomy chapter 13, verse 1. It says, If there arise among you a prophet or a dreamer of dreams
mm-hmm.
and gives you a sign or wonder, and the sign or the wonder come to pass where he spoke unto you, saying, Let us go after other gods which you have not known, and let us serve them. Verse 3, You shall not hearken unto the words of that prophet or that dreamer of dreams, for the Lord your God proves you.
Mm-hmm.
To know whether you love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. So we see that's the same thing that happened with Abraham.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That's right. The word of God confirms itself in the mouth of two or three witnesses. Praise
Hallelujah.
God for
Amen.
That. Excuse me. All right. So he says, verse number 2 in Genesis chapter 22, he says, And offer him there for a burnt offering. Forgive me. For a burnt offering, that's a whole burnt offering, okay?
Amen.
An offering that is wholly consumed.
Amen.
Okay? By God. Now, upon one of the mountains, which I will tell you of. Now, that in and of itself speaks volumes.
Amen.
Praise God. The only offering that the Father would accept or could accept, okay, was a whole burnt offering, an offering that was wholly consumed.
Hallelujah.
By God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Okay, and we understand that the Lord Jesus was full of grace and truth. He was he was filled without measure of the Holy Ghost,
Amen.
The Spirit of love. Praise
Amen.
God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. All right, so he was the only acceptable whole burnt offering.
Amen.
All right, and he says, and Abraham rose up early, okay? So he was in a hurry to be about his father's business. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Just like the Lord Jesus said, he said, my father had no pleasure, praise God, in these burnt offerings, praise God.
Amen.
He said, lo, I come.
In the volume.
Praise God. In the volume of the book. Praise
Hallelujah.
God. To do your will, oh God. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. I desire above all
Hallelujah.
Else. To That's please right. my father,
father
who loves me.
Amen.
So.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory
Praise God. God. And I mean, this text is really just so rich. I mean, we could really just stay here for several weeks.
Amen.
But we just going to kind of continue through for the sake of time. But he says it's just such an awesome and beautiful testimony. Okay. Praise God. All right. He says, and Abraham rose up early in the morning. Praise God. The expository study note here says prompt obedience. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All right. And saddled his donkey and took two of his young men with him and Isaac, his son, and clave the wood for the burnt offering and rose up and went unto the place of which God had told him. Praise
yes, Lord.
God.
Yes, Lord.
All right. So he followed the
Thank
Lord's
Lord.
Directives specifically.
Amen.
Praise God. He followed the way of the Lord, okay?
Amen.
And he is the father of faith. Hallelujah.
Glory
Praise
God.
God. Because he accepted God's perception above his own.
That's right.
Hallelujah. And the Lord expects us to do the same. Now
yes,
he says,
does.
Then on the third day, Abraham lifted up his eyes. Hallelujah. Praise God. And we know that the Lord Jesus rose up. Praise
Hallelujah.
God. On the third day. Hallelujah.
Glory
and he saw the place afar off. Hallelujah. Praise God. And the expository study note says this was no doubt the longest 3 days of Abraham's life, okay?
Amen.
All right? Because this is a father giving up his promise,
Hallelujah.
Okay?
Thank
giving
God.
Up his only begotten son, praise God. And the wisdom of God chose to document
Thank you, Lord.
Whom he loved.
Amen.
Praise God. All right, and he says, and Abraham said unto his young men, abide you here with the donkey, and I and the lad will go yonder and worship. You see, he viewed this as
Hallelujah.
An act of worship. He viewed believing the Father's report.
Amen.
Praise God.
That's right.
As an act of worship.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank
Hallelujah.
You.
Praise God. So, praise God.
Amen.
Accepting the faith of the Lord, praise God, is
Amen.
An act of worship.
Worship
All
is
right?
who we are. And praise is what we do.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
He says, and I and the lad will go yonder and worship and come again to you. So he already knew, praise God, that even if the Heavenly Father did have him to sacrifice his son, praise God.
Hey.
He was well
hey.
Able, praise God.
Raise him
and
up.
He was faithful
Glory
to raise
to
him back up, praise God. He is the one who gave him the miracle because he
God
is the
Almighty.
God of miracles.
Glory
Hallelujah.
That's right.
Hallelujah. He is the God of miracles. He is the God of love. He is the faithful one.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you,
praise
Lord.
Praise God.
Glory
so he
to God.
Knew, praise God, in whom he believed. Hallelujah.
Well pleased.
Hallelujah. Praise God. He rose up in a hurry to go and be about the Father's business. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. And he viewed walking in the faith as an act of a worship. Praise God. And he says, we're going to go worship and then we're going to come again to you. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
And he says, and Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it up on Isaac, his son. Praise God.
Thank you, Father.
And he took the fire in his hand and a knife, and they went both of them together. Praise God. You see, so this was a collective agreement. Praise God. As we read over in the book of 1 John chapter 4, hallelujah, praise God. This was an agreement from the Holy Trinity. Praise God.
Amen.
The Father and the Son, praise God, and the Holy Spirit, they were all three in one accord. Praise God. They were all three in agreement, praise God, that this thing should be done.
Amen.
Praise God. For love's sake.
Thus the 3 days. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost.
God the Holy Ghost. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. You know, we actually have confirmation of that over in some other scriptures, but we won't actually make it there tonight. But glory be to God for the sake of time. But we're going to continue forward. So he says, and praise God, and Isaac spoke unto Abraham, his father, and said, my father, hallelujah, praise God. The expositor study note here says, Isaac, as the unresisting burnt offering, is a striking type of him who said, I delight to do your will, oh my God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The father's love. So we see the father's love for his son, but we also see the son's love for his father. Praise God. Hallelujah. This is a beautiful picture. All right. And he said, here am I, my son. And he said, behold the fire and the wood. Praise God. But where is the lamb for a burnt offering? Praise God. All right. And then the expository study note here goes right back over to where we were earlier. He says, John the Baptist would answer that question by saying, behold the Lamb of God, which takes away the sin of the world.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. That was St. John chapter 1 and verse 29. We read it earlier. Praise God. But that's, for, it, you know, the Word of God just builds up on itself. Praise
Amen.
God. It's further confirmation. Yes, sir.
Amen. And you know, right there, honey, where it says, and he said, here am I, my son.
Mm-hmm.
That's the same thing God told Moses at the burning bush. Mm-hmm. Tell him that I am sent you.
That's right. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Praise God. That's right.
Iron sharp as iron.
That's it. Praise God. That's right. This was done, praise God, by the I am, praise
yes,
God,
amen.
Because man was lost and desolate and alone, praise God. We
Hallelujah.
Were totally without hope, praise God.
Desolate.
And the Word of God records that there was nobody else that even cared.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
On my way to
we were lost and on our way to a fiery, burning hell. And
right.
Nobody. But the Savior.
Hallelujah.
Nobody.
Thank you, Lord.
But Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank
cared.
You, Father.
Okay.
Glory to your
Nobody
name.
Else was worthy.
Nobody. Glory to his name.
To take the book. Praise God.
Jesus.
Nobody.
Thank you, Father.
Okay. So we praise God for the opportunity to know him. Praise God. We praise God for the manner of love that has been bestowed upon
Hallelujah.
Us. Hallelujah. Praise
Thank
God. And he says, and Abraham said, my son, God will provide. Hallelujah.
That's right.
Hallelujah. God will provide
Hallelujah.
Himself a lamb for a burnt offering.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. So they went both of them together. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
Praise God. And he says, let's see, the expository study note here reads, Isaac was to be a type of the Son of God provided by the Lord, who would redeem mankind by the giving of himself in sacrifice on the cross. Praise
Hallelujah.
God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
All right.
Hallelujah.
And we continue forward. He says, and they came to the place which God had told him of. Praise God.
Amen.
And the expository study note here says this would be the place of the threshing floor which David bought and where Solomon's temple would be built. Praise God.
Amen.
And Abraham built an altar there. Praise Amen. God. Excuse me. Continue forward, and he says, and laid the wood in order. Praise
order.
God. Glory and the Lord God. Expects us to do the same
right.
regarding the cross. Praise
in
God.
Order.
The cross does not go, as Pastor Harris pointed out.
Glory
praise
God.
God. According to the word of God, the cross, the physical, the literal cross does not go in front of God.
Hallelujah.
That's in front of the Lord Jesus. Okay. The Lamb of God. That would be the same thing as putting man in front of God.
Amen.
Okay, because as Pastor Harris pointed out, that tree that he hung upon represented us.
That's
praise
right.
God.
That's
but
right.
he laid there. Love held him to that cross. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So that the wrath of God will fall upon him, the
That's
one
right.
who was able to handle it. Praise God.
Glory
instead
to God.
Of us,
Hallelujah.
Who could not handle
Hallelujah.
Anything.
Glory
as we read
name.
Earlier, man cannot handle the wrath or the indignation of the living God. Praise God. What a fearful thing it is to fall into the hand of a living God. You see. But God so loved the world.
Yes, he did.
Hallelujah.
Yes, he does.
That he gave his only begotten son in whom he was well, is well.
Hallelujah.
Pleased.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
And he says, and bound Isaac, his son, and laid him on the altar upon the wood. Praise God. Okay. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son. And the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham, praise God. You see, the expository study note here reads, he who said Abraham, Abraham, was the same one who said Martha, Martha, Simon, Simon, and Saul, Saul. The repetition denotes urgency because you see, this man of faith, Abraham rose up early with prompt obedience to go and be about the Father's business.
Yes, he did.
He was ready and willing to give up his joy.
Amen.
Okay.
That's right. That's right.
He was ready and willing to give it up, to give him up to please the Father. Praise God. Okay. Just like the Word of God tells us, we won't make it there tonight, that it pleased the Father to bruise his son in
That's
order
right.
that we might be saved.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Okay. That is the manner of love that the Father hath bestowed upon us. Praise God. And he says, glory be to God. And he said, lay not your hand. I'm sorry. Forgive me. And he said, here am I. Praise God.
Amen.
So again, that speaks of the great I am.
The
praise
great
God.
I am. That's right.
Here is the provision that you needed. Praise God.
Amen.
It was already prepared. Hallelujah. And he said, lay not your hand upon the lad, neither do you anything unto him. For now I know, praise God, that you fear God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
That's
it is
right.
the beginning of knowledge. Praise
That's right.
God.
Glory
Hallelujah.
To God.
Praise God. It is that which protects our very lives. For now I know that you fear God, seeing ye have not withheld
Thank you, Lord.
Your son, your only son
Thank you, Lord.
From me. Praise God. He says, should have the expository study note here reads, should have been translated, for I, the knowing one, knew that you feared God. Now that I agree with, praise God, and that you would not withhold your son, your only son, from me. Praise
yes,
God.
Lord.
The word of God tells us, if God would not even withhold his only begotten son,
That's
praise
right.
God,
Glory to
how
God.
Much more,
Glory to God.
You know, would he give us, what is it that he would behold? When he gave us his greatest treasure, Praise God. He gave us heaven's best. Praise God. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in a thicket by his horns. Now, the expository study note here reads, this is the doctrine of substitution plainly laid out. The ram was offered up in sacrifice instead of his son. Likewise, the Lord Jesus, praise God, was offered up as our substitute.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
And that thicket of thorns, praise God, that was upon his head, what, you know, denotes to us, praise God, that he was carrying the cares of, you know, of our cares,
our lives,
this life, praise God, on his mind. He was carrying our concerns on his mind, praise God. Okay.
Hallelujah. So, thank you, Lord.
Praise God. Hallelujah. All right. So he did it all for us. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering in the stead of his son.
Amen.
Praise God.
Glory
all right.
God.
And the Lord does the same, has done the same for us. Praise God. You see,
yes,
he
Lord.
Has given us the Lamb of God. Praise God. He has given us the Ram of Heaven. Praise
Amen.
God. The Lion from the tribe of Judah. Praise God.
That's right.
He has given us one who is holy, pure.
Amen.
Holy, innocent. Praise
Amen.
God.
The Lion and the Lamb.
The Lion and the Lamb. Praise God. He has given him to us. Praise God.
Amen.
And the Lord Jesus said he came willingly. It was his choice to come.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Praise God. Praise God. For love's sake, praise
yes,
God.
Lord.
This is why, praise God, it behooves us, okay, for that we would look intently into this great mystery of love. Praise God.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. And allow the spirit of grace, the spirit of love, even the spirit of truth to reveal to us the heart of the Christ, the heart of the Father regarding his Son. Praise God. Praise God. With that, for the sake of time, we're going to go ahead and close out for tonight, unless my husband has something to add at this time.
Amen. I just wanted to read just a little bit more, honey, if I may.
Okay.
It says, verse 15, and the angel of the Lord called upon Abraham out of heaven the second time, and said, by myself have I sworn, says the Lord, for because you have done this thing, you have not withheld your son, your only son, that in blessing I will bless you, and in multiplying I will multiply you, your seed, as the stars of the heaven, and as the sand which is upon the seashore. And your seed shall possess the gate of his enemies. So we see here with his obedience,
praise
not
God.
Withholding the gift that God had given him.
Mm-hmm.
He would not withhold. And we have to be the same way, saints.
Amen.
We can't have anything that stands between us and our God.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing is that important.
Nothing at all.
Your wife shouldn't. Your husband shouldn't.
Mm-hmm.
You love and cherish them. They are the litmus test for us. But nothing stands between them and our God. There's a scripture that says, unless you forsake your mother, your father, your sister, your brother, and prefer me, you are not worthy of the kingdom.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bless his name this night. Glory to his name.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's all I had to say.
Praise God. And with that, praise God, we're going to go ahead and close out in prayer. Honey, would you do the honors, please?
Certainly. Thank you, Father. Let us bow our heads. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word, Lord. We thank you, O Lord, for leading us and guiding us. We thank you for exposing and opening up the scriptures to us, Heavenly Father. We thank you for allowing your spirit to be amongst us, to lead us and guide us in all truth, understanding, wisdom, and knowledge, Father. Lord, we thank you tonight. Hallelujah. We magnify your name, Father. Only you and you alone are worthy. The great I am, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Whatever we need, hallelujah. The very hairs on our head are numbered. Father, we thank you tonight. We thank you for your word. We hope and pray that someone in our YouTube family, we may have said something, oh Lord, to give peace to one who is weary in a time of need, Father. We pray for Israel. We pray for Benjamin Netanyahu. We ask, O Lord, that you give them the saving knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. We pray for Donald John Trump and his family, Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, let thy will be done. We pray for Pastor Victor E. Harris and Sister Sid Harris, the under-shepherds of this body of believers, Father, in the name. We thank you for your word, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you for the living word, and thank you for your written word. Glory to God. And opening up the scriptures to us to where we could understand, Father. Glory to God. We thank you for the understanding. We thank you for the illumination. We thank you for the dominion. We thank you for the understanding, Father. For the eyes of our understanding has been opened. We magnify your name, Father. We love you with everything we have. We'll always be ever so careful to lift you up before all mankind. Let thy will be done. Let thy kingdom come. We pray for our YouTube family. Go, Holy Ghost. Do the Lord's will in the lives of the people. We pray for the angel of harvest. For you said that the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Help us to labor earnestly, Father, being led by the Spirit in all we say and do. And Father, we thank you. We thank you for hearing our prayers, our supplications. We just thank you, Father, for all things. All things good come from you. Let thy will be done. Let thy kingdom come. And Lord, we love you. We thank you. And we ask all these in the Lord Jesus' name. The church said amen, amen, and amen. Glory to his name, Father.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord.